Now we'll see how to derive the problem in quantum mechanics by variation principle using Gaussian trial function. The problem is estimate the ground state energy of a one-dimensional harmonic oscillator of mass m and angular frequency omega using a Gaussian trial wave function. I have taken this problem from quantum mechanics by Arul Das. Here it is given that the trial wave function is a Gaussian function, so we are taking phi is equal to e power minus alpha x squared. In order to make this trial wave function as the normalized one, I have included n. So phi is equal to n e power minus alpha x squared, where n is the normalization constant and alpha is also a constant. So here the system is for the harmonic oscillator. So the Hamiltonian for the harmonic oscillator is h is equal to minus h cross squared divided by 2m d squared by dx squared plus half m omega squared x squared. Here it is given that it is a one-dimensional problem. So we have taken only the x. So now we have to find out the expectation value of h. So the expectation value of h is rho phi h ket phi. Now if it is a normalized one, this is the equation. Now we have to take the trial wave function and normalize the trial wave function. So in order to normalize it, the probability of phi should be equal to 1. So if you take the probability, it is equal to n squared and e power minus alpha x squared and ket e power minus alpha x squared is equal to 1. So it is n squared into integral from minus infinity to plus infinity e power minus 2 alpha x squared dx. Now if it is a standard integral, so if you integrate, it is equal to n squared square root of pi by 2 alpha, that is equal to 1. So using this, we can find n is equal to 2 alpha by pi whole power 1 by 4. So phi is equal to 2 alpha by pi whole power 1 by 4 e power minus 2 alpha x squared. This is our trial wave function. And now the expectation value of h is, you have to substitute the value of h here. So it is minus h cross squared divided by 2m. The expectation value of d squared by dx squared plus half m omega squared and expectation value of x squared. Now you have to find out the first term, that is the expectation value of d by dx squared. Now you substitute the value of phi here and it is equal to minus 2 alpha by pi whole power half 2 alpha, the probability of e power minus alpha x squared, plus 4 alpha squared 2 alpha by pi whole power half the expectation value of x squared. How you are getting this? That is, you are differentiating this d squared by dx squared will act on e power minus alpha x squared. So this you can write it as d by dx of e power minus alpha squared. That is, d squared by dx squared can be written as d by dx of d by dx. Okay. So if you differentiate this first, it becomes minus 2 alpha into e power minus e power minus alpha x squared. So once again you have to differentiate. So it becomes minus 2 alpha e power minus alpha x squared minus 2 alpha x squared e power minus alpha x squared. Okay. So using this equation number 7a, you have written the equation 7. So once again, here each part you have to calculate. First you will calculate the probability of e power minus alpha x squared, that is equal to integral from minus infinity to plus infinity e power minus 2 alpha x squared dx. So this is the standard integral. If you integrate, it is equal to square root of pi by 2 alpha. Now we have to find the expectation value of x squared, that is equal to integral from minus infinity to plus infinity x squared e power minus 2 alpha x squared dx. Here I have taken this as I, and this is of the form integral u dv is equal to uv minus integral v du. So I have taken u as x. So du is dx and dv is x e power minus 2 alpha x square dx. In that I multiply and divide by minus 4 alpha. So in the numerator you have minus 4 alpha x e power minus 2 alpha x square dx. This is the numerator is nothing but differentiation of e power minus 2 alpha x square. So I have written this as minus of 1 by 4 alpha differentiation of e power minus 2 alpha x square. So v is equal to minus e power minus 2 alpha x square divided by 4 alpha. Now you substitute in the integral u dv formula, then I is equal to minus e power minus 2 alpha x square divided by 4 alpha into x, and substituting the limit minus infinity to infinity plus integral from minus infinity to infinity e power minus 2 alpha x square divided by 4 alpha dx. So here if you substitute the first limit in the first term, it becomes 0. So the remaining term is 1 by 4 alpha into integral from minus infinity to plus infinity e power minus 2 alpha x square dx. This is, you know, it's the standard integral. If you multiply, if you integrate, it is 1 by 4 alpha square root of pi by 2 alpha. Now you have found out all the terms corresponding to the first term. So now you substitute all in equation 7. It becomes the expectation value of d squared by dx squared is equal to minus square root of 2 alpha by pi, 2 alpha, pi by 2 alpha the square root plus square root of 2 alpha by pi into 4 alpha squared into 1 by 4 alpha into square root of pi by 2 alpha. Now if you simplify all these terms, you can get it is equal to minus alpha. Now you know the value of all. Now you substitute all these values in equation number 6. It becomes expectation value of h is equal to minus h cross square divided by 2m minus alpha plus half m omega squared into 1 by 4 alpha. So that is equal to, if you simplify, this is h cross square divided into alpha divided by 2m plus 1 by 8 alpha m omega squared. Now if you are according to the variation principle, you have to vary the parameter in such a way that the expectation value of h should be minimum. So in order to find out that, you are differentiating with respect to alpha and making it to 0. So from that you can find out the alpha. So if you differentiate and equating to 0, you can get alpha is equal to m omega by 2 h cross. So if you substitute this value in equation 8, it becomes expectation value is equal to half h cross omega. So here it is approximately equal to the exact value. So it is, that means you have taken the trial wave function as an exact wave function. Okay, thank you.